everyone, and welcome to the first episode of The Five Count. I'm your host, Dilly, and today I'm going to be explaining why Nirvana is one of, if not the greatest bands of all time. So let's get right into the list. Number 5, Nirvana put grunge on the map. Before Nirvana, grunge wasn't really a big deal. It existed, but it wasn't huge. Like, nobody really cared about it. It was really a small subculture. And of course, there were grunge bands before Nirvana, but Nirvana is what brought grunge to the mainstream. And that's exactly what they did. Punk, of course, was also there with grunge before Nirvana, but punk and grunge are two, they're similar to an extent, but obviously grunge is the more like alternative, you know, it's its own thing. It has a whole different lifestyle. Everything about it is different. But I think Nirvana truly brought the grunge slash alternative rock genre into the mainstream. Number 4, they inspired an entire generation. Back in the 90s, I was not alive, sadly, but it was huge with grunge. Grunge was a huge deal. And that's partly thanks to Nirvana. Of course, MTV played Nirvana non-stop back in the day, with other grunge bands as well, which I guess could kind of also be attributed to Nirvana. I think they definitely inspired a lot of bands to do that style. But grunge was a huge deal in the 90s. The grunge style is also huge. Ripped jeans, bad t-shirts, baggy t-shirts. That kind of stuff even still lives on today. I see people roaming the hallways at school all the time with their ripped jeans and their band shirts, and it's great for the most part until you go up to them and ask them what their favorite Nirvana song is, and they can't say because they haven't listened to them. Number 3, they inspired countless artists. Now, any artist that you listen to as a viewer, I'm sure, has listened to Nirvana and has gained some inspiration. Now, I do have a list compiled of some artists that you may have heard of that have listed Nirvana as some of their influences. Weezer was definitely inspired by Nirvana. They said this multiple times. Oasis was also inspired by Nirvana. The Gallagher brothers, I should say, said in multiple interviews that they are big fans of Nirvana. Seether was very heavily inspired by Nirvana, as you can tell by the vocals, the style, like everything about Seether kinda has a Nirvana feel to an extent. Muse was another band that was inspired by Nirvana, and I mean, they're definitely a different band. They don't really sound like Nirvana, but their inspiration is there. And some artists that everybody knows in this day and age, Post Malone, huge Nirvana fan, very inspired by Nirvana, and Billie Eilish was as well. She's actually been doing a lot of things with Dave Grohl and Dave Grohl's daughter as of late, and I mean, that's pretty cool for the guy that used to be the drummer in Nirvana. Number 2, their styles varied with very good results. And what I mean by this is maybe every album has just a plethora of different songs on it. Like, they're not all the same. They all sound a little bit different. Like, for example, you want a heavy song? Look at Endless, Nameless, Milk It, or Scentless Apprentice. You want pure grunge? Literally anything from Bleach. Two songs I can recommend would be School and Blue. You want something chill? Look at Lithium, Come As You Are, and Polly. Very chill songs. And you want something sad? Something in the Way, Sappy, Dumb. Some very good things. You name it, Nirvana's done it. And number 1, they did not have a bad album. Now, of course, this whole video has been pretty subjective, and this one's a very subjective point as well, but let's look at their discography. The first album they put out was Bleach, and that was pure grunge gold. That just breathed the essence of grunge. It was very good. Nevermind is their second album, and it's literally the best album of all time. And I'm not just saying that, you could ask a lot of people, including Rolling Stone. They did a magazine a couple months ago about the greatest albums of all time, and Nirvana, Nevermind, was number 1. In Utero, good album. They had some pretty good songs, unlike Heart Shaped Box, for example. Some very good songs came off In Utero, and Incesticide doesn't really count. It was their last studio album, but it was more or less B-sides and like outtakes, stuff like that. It still wasn't bad, but it doesn't really count. I wouldn't say it's a great album. It's not bad. I personally love it, but I'd understand why somebody else wouldn't. But it's all B-sides, so it doesn't really matter. Ladies and gentlemen, that's 5 reasons that Nirvana is one of the greatest, if not the greatest band of all time. Obviously, Nirvana is my favorite band. I love Nirvana. Everything about Nirvana is great. But I considered making a video about Nirvana this past Wednesday because that guy, one of the fellas on YouTube, made a video explaining why he hates Nirvana. I can't even think of the dude's name. Is that Become the Night, I think is his name. He made a video, he's like, why I hate Nirvana. I didn't even watch it, because man, you do you. You hate Nirvana, that's fine. But you gotta look at why they are truly one of the greatest bands of all time. And I decided to make this video today because it is Kurt Cobain's birthday. He would have been 53 years old today, and it's a damn shame that he's gone. Obviously, he didn't live the best lifestyle, he didn't necessarily take care of himself like he should have, and obviously, drugs and stuff all became a factor in his life. He ended up shooting his head off in 1994. Damn shame. The dude was an artist, and, you know, it is what it is. I'm sure if he saw this video, he'd probably shoot himself again. Just because he didn't necessarily like praise. He didn't like seeing all the attention they were getting. And he's said that multiple times. So, I mean, it is what it is. But Nirvana is definitely one of my favorite bands of all time. And they're one of the greatest bands of all time. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe more. And click the bell icon for the love of God. So you know every time I post. Follow me on Instagram at Project Melanta. It's going to be changing soon. And follow my grunge page. I actually have one that I've been meaning to talk about on this channel. It's at BeGrungeBrand. It's me and a buddy. We post grunge things. We've been pretty inactive, but we're kind of coming back. I have a video posted over there, or it's going to be posted over there soon, that you might want to see. It's going to be a CD unboxing and a discography review of System of a Down. So go check that out, the page. The video should be up either today or tomorrow. It'll be up soon. So anyways, guys, I've been your host, Dilly, signing out.